So I'm presenting our work on learning end-to-end image processing pipeline. This is work done with Raja Jiris and Alex Bronstein. Great, so I will start with a marketing slide. The number of photos captured is increasing year to year, and more than a trillion images are captured per year. And most of them are captured using our mobile phones. Our mobile phones has an inherent problem. They are small in size, and they have small sensors. Small sensors means we face the noise versus motion artifacts trade-off. If we capture the image with a short exposure time, we will get a very noisy signal. If we take a longer exposure, we will suffer from motion artifacts. So traditionally, image processing is done in the ISP, the image processing pipeline. The input is a bare patterned, more mosaiced image. So we have a optical mask on top of the sensor. So each pixel only samples one color, either red, green, or blue. And we have to complete the missing information. So this is our raw image. And it's passed through a sequence of different tasks, different algorithms. These are traditionally, these are heavily engineered algorithms that tons of literature on every specific task. And at the end, we get to the final RGB image. So our goal is to learn the mapping from the raw image to the final RGB image, in doing it in a deep learning based model. So the advantage of doing it with learning end to end is that jointly solving multiple tasks or all tasks allows the different algorithms, kind of algorithms, to share information. Hopefully, this will help. It has been shown in the past for when combining, let's say, denoising and demosaicing, two different tasks. But our claim is that doing everything end to end will help even better. And also, we would like to claim that it's better in the since it's as a constant time, constant complexity. Which means if we have a better data set, better ground truth images, we will learn a better algorithm with the same complexity. So we built a data set. The data set is captured with Samsung's S7 camera. We have for every scene, we can see on the right, the automatically, an image captured in automatic, fully automatic settings. And on the left, you can see a low light version of it. We captured the low light image by just shortening the exposure time. So this way we easily get, of course, the camera is mounted on the tripod. We get the low light image and its corresponding well lit image. For each image, we also have the raw version. So, and our goal is to map from the low light, we'll train a model to map the low light raw image to the final RGB well lit image. So I will present our model. It's fully convolutional, which means we can support any input resolution. It's based on small convolutions with skip connections. Surprisingly, it works well. We start with the low level part. The low level part is responsible for local corrections to the image. It's again, as I said, it's small convolutions and skip connections. So for every block, we compute a feature, the features for the pixel, and also a residual image. The residual image is added to the input image and then passed on to the next block. This is done for between 10 to 20 layers. Then we get to the high level part. It gets its input as inputted the features from the previous layer for, and the locally corrected image. It computes a global transformation of the image. It's a global transformation that applied pixel wise. And it's just a polynomial of a second degree applied per pixel on its R, G, and B values. And this is, so this is the model. The loss, so usually L2 loss is used, but L2 has its problems. It's usually suffer from convergence to the mean, which means we get as an output a very blurry image. So L1 is better. And also SSIM is usually used for measuring the distance between pair of images, working in a patch level and computing the statistics, the local statistics, such which is the STD and the mean. Luckily, it's differentiable, so we can use it as a loss. And combining so, and we apply also we all apply it in a for multiscales. Combining it all, we get L1 loss plus the multiscale SSIM loss. We show some results. So for joint denoising and demosaicing, we start with joint denoising and demosaicing because for this task, we have a objective measure, which is the PSNR. So this is a subset of the full pipeline we are aiming at. For this part, we only use the low-level part of the network, and we optimize for L2. We get a state-of-the-art results for this task. You can see on the last line, up to 1.5 dB compared to a best to top results so far, even comparing to other deep learning based models. On the left is the ground truth. In the middle is the what happens when you try to do demosaicing with a simple bilinear interpolation. So you can see on the top image the zippering on edges. And on the lower image, you can see how blurry it is. This is our results. You can see we got rid of the zippering and also the image is quite sharp. We move on to the full ISP. In the full ISP, the task is mapping the raw low light image to the final RGB well-lit image. So for this task, there are no real objective metrics, because let's say I have a very small shift in color that is invisible, it will still call if I will measure, let's say in L2, I will get a very large distance if it's a constant, let's say it's a bias over the whole image. So here we use a mean opinion score. So we let Amazon Mechanical Turk workers to rate images. They do it both for a full image and for patches, random patches from the images. The random patches are for rating the level of details and the global image, of course, it's the global and the general appearance. And also use a DeepIQA, which is a deep learning model trained for assessing image quality. We found out that this is not our word, DeepIQA, it's just used their code, and we found out that it's highly correlated with the human ratings. So these are the results. You can see on the left is the mean opinion score per patch, and in the middle it's the mean opinion score per for the full image, and on the right is the DeepIQA rating. You can see that we win over Samsung's, the manufacturer's ISP in all of them. And for the full image, we get almost as good results as the ground truth images. This is an example of our results. So on the middle, you can see the manufacturer's results. And on the right is the results for our results for the same input raw image. Here are some snippets from the image. I'm not sure how much you can see on this screen, but there are much more details. Here is another example. I guess you don't see any difference, but believe me, there is. we reconstruct much more details. Maybe here you can see that for Samsung's images, they're very noisy compared to ours. So Samsung's ISP obviously is highly engineered and specific for the and used some information on the hardware calibrated in lab, etc. So to summarize, we show a very simple way for generating pairs of low light images and the counterparts well lit images. We show that a very simple architecture of small convolutions with skip connections can produce state-of-the-art results for image processing tasks such as joint denoising and demosaicing. And when combining local and global image correction, we can get high-quality images for the full end-to-end image processing pipeline. Thank you.